Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about how to differentiate unilateral from bilateral BPPV. Many a time when we do the Dix-Halpike test, we are often faced with positive test on both sides and we are in a dilemma whether it is bilateral BPPV. Now, when you have nystagmus on both sides, a useful thing which I found from literature was to determine based on the torsional component whether it is same sense nystagmus or different sense nystagmus. What I mean by this, you will understand in the videos that follow. I had a 35-year-old male without any comorbidities who had positional vertigo, and when I did the Dix-Halpike test for him, he had a positive test on both sides. At this juncture, I would also like to tell you that the symptoms and the nystagmus was more pronounced on one side than the other. In his case, it was the right side. When we look at the video of the right Dix-Halpike test, notice that the patient is having a counterclockwise or a geotrophic vertical torsional nystagmus. Now, I told you about the same sense and the opposite sense in Dix-Halpike test. We'll talk about it after looking at the second video. In the left Dix-Halpike test, you have a vertical torsional nystagmus again. I told you at the beginning itself that the intensity of this nystagmus was a little lower than the one which we got on the right side. The patient's symptoms also was less pronounced. Now this nystagmus, if you see, just take the torsional component, you see that it is beating in the apogeotrophic or the same counterclockwise direction. So, the nystagmus on the right side and the left side, I would call it same sense in this patient. Why so? Because the torsional component is beating in the counterclockwise direction. To conclude, I would like to say that if you have a same sense nystagmus on doing the Dix-Halpike, it is more likely to be a unilateral than a bilateral BPPV. And if you have an opposite sense nystagmus, I'm talking only with respect to the torsional component, it is more likely to be a bilateral BPPV. It is important to follow up the patient and do a repeat positional testing and make sure that the BPPV has resolved. A few cases have been documented where the hypothesis that I said may not exist. So it may be a multi-canal BPPV, so the initial testing would not have revealed the multi-canal. So it's important to observe these patients. Thank you for listening.